Aloha, my name is Dr. Stephanie Hahn, and I just came down from the Cocoa Head Trail. And today I'd like to answer a question that was directed to me by a high school teacher. Dear Dr. Hahn, how do I get kids to write openly and freely? This is a good question, and this is one that plagues a lot of secondary teachers in particular. First of all, you have to emphasize ideas of reading and have a very broad and interesting reading list. I don't know why, but there are a lot of boring books that are still taught for secondary teachers. There's also this kind of attitude that because they were taught to the teachers when teachers were young and teachers were engaged with these texts, that they're still going to be engaging for students who are very unlike them in terms of experience. Now, for the most part, a lot of students are not going to become English majors. And this is something that as an English literature teacher, you often have a hard time accepting because you love to read so much, you assume that your students like to read. And this is really simply not the case. There is a book for everyone, I do believe that. But in terms of how people intake stories, it's very different for many different kinds of kids. So the way that you get to write them openly and freely is to set up a situation where they feel very free to comment about anything. So your discussion cannot have a lot of rules in terms of, no, you can't say that about a character, or that's really not a nice thing to write, that's not a nice thing to say. In particular, adolescents, they don't want to be nice. They want to be rebellious. They want to be outrageous. Yeah, I mean, they want to be kind, but really it's about exploration and pushing boundaries. So I'm going to give you an example of someone who really didn't understand this. I taught briefly with a teacher who I understood was completely horrified because a student had handed in an essay which featured, I don't know, dismembering of small animal parts and cannibalism and people with red eyes and, you know, weird things like that. And she then attributed it to the kid being completely imbalanced, and she was worried. She said that the student shouldn't really write that kind of thing. Obviously, she had never heard of an entire genre of literature called horror. And, but I'd like to say that this type of teacher is very common in secondary schools. This is the kind of teacher that sets the rules and the kind of teacher that shuts down a lot of conversation. If in your class, students say things that seem outrageous or, you know, how can they say that? You're incredulous. It's okay. It means that they're very free to speak. We can always guide the conversation, but we should foster debate always. And if you have a classroom that fosters debate, that encourages ideas of inquiry and questioning, you will inevitably get students who are more free to express who they are on the page. Okay? And that's it for today. And if you have any other questions, please email me at drstephaniehahn.com. Bye.